Fallout Equestria the Chrysalis, Chapter 9, Part 3. The Starlight halted and grimaced.
That's really not good.
Dusty halted at the top of the stairs. What? What's wrong?
That,
she said, pointing to the water.
The water. You can't see where you're stepping.
We'll just have to be careful then, he replied, but she gave a sharp shake of her head.
Very careful,
Starlight said.
That's got an infection written all over it, and who knows what you could step on under there. You know what tetanus does to a pony? Oh, for fuck's sake.
Sickle growled as she shoved past Dusty and made her way down the stairs.
Move your asses already, I'm ready to be done with this shit.
She waded out, unconcerned about underwater obstacles with her heavy shoes. Then she paused.
The fuck way are we going anyway? That way.
Starlight said, sighing as she gestured to our left and reluctantly followed. She dipped her hoof gingerly into the water, only to jerk it back as if bit.
Holy shit, that's cold,
she said as she slowly slid it in again. The water reached up to her knees. I took a moment to fully power down my portable terminal before entering, and craned my head back to keep it lifted well clear of the water. And Starlight was right. The water was icy. The dank, stagnant smell suggested it wasn't very healthy either. Starlight muttered as we went.
We're in the middle of a desert. Where did all of this water come from?
She snorted, and immediately answered her own question.
It's probably just rainwater. At least that should mean that there's a way out.
We waded through the muck while the few working lights struggled to illuminate our path. The splashing of our movements echoed down the damp tunnel, and I winced every time my hooves bumped into something with my shuffling steps. Some were rocks or other hard objects, and occasionally, it was squishy. After 100 yards of wading through the muck, we came across to another set of stairs, leading up to another platform. We happily made our way to dry land, shaking off the cold water and stomping our hooves to shake off the muck that clung to them. I felt foul, and made a note to not touch my face until I'd gotten the chance to wash my hooves thoroughly. I'd idly wondered if Emerald stocked soap. One door led out from the platform, locked with a keypad and festooned with warning signs. The most prominent declared the space beyond is property of Equestrian Robotics, warning that all unauthorized personnel would face not just potential prosecution of trespassing and possible espionage during a time of war, but also the lethal security systems intended to protect the facility, its workers, and the nation they all served. All in all, a fairly standard warning in wartime Equestria, as depressing as that is. Unlike the keypads we had encountered before, this one was now powered. Starlight stepped up, her tools already floating before her.
Give me a minute, I got this.
As she pried off the keypad's case, Dusty looked to me.
Cover the rear, they might follow us, and if we can catch them knee-deep in water, all the better.
I nodded, moving back to the top of the stairs to lie down, my rifle pointing down to the dimly lit tunnel. I stared off into the gloom, listening to the thrum of machinery and the clicking of Starlight's tools. A faint buzz sounded from the door.
Got it,
Starlight declared, followed by the grinding as she pulled the door open. In the next instant, there was an angry beep, a sharp yelp of surprise from Starlight, a clatter of hooves, and an ear-hammering blast of gunfire. I spun around to see chips of concrete flying as bullets sailed through the open doorway to blast chunks out of the concrete pad beyond.
Turret!
Starlight called out as she scrambled away from the doorway and turned around. Her hind leg nearly went out and she turned again to look back at her flank.
Oh, shit,
she said, her voice oddly calm.
It hit me.
My heart lurched, blood running cold. She turned in a circle, trying to get a better look at her flank, and staggering when her right hind leg supported her. I scrambled up as her flank came back into view. At first, she looked uninjured. It took me a moment to notice the wound, a tiny blemish just in front of her cutie mark. She lifted her hoof to continue the turn, the muscles of her thigh flexed, and blood flowed from the wound in a thick surge.
Oh shit,
she repeated, her hoof stepping down again, and she staggered again. This time, her leg gave out and she toppled over.
I got shot,
she said, eyes wide and staring at Dusty as I hurried over to her.
It shot me. Oh shit, it shot me.
The moment Dusty's hoof touched her side, she jerked away.
Don't touch it,
she shouted, her horn lighting up to shove Dusty back. I had to give her credit, she could put a good amount of force into it. The shove sent him staggering back to fall on his rump.
You'll get it infected! Oh shit.
He was immediately up, hurrying back over, though he didn't put a hoof on her just yet.
You're bleeding,
he said, as I came skidding to a halt by Starlight's head. She had rolled onto her side, wounded flank up. The wound was still for a moment, but then the blood flowed again, pulsing with her heartbeat.
You're bleeding bad, Dusty corrected. Bleeding first, then infection.
Starlight was already pulling open her bags, digging out medical supplies.
I can fix this. Just don't touch it. You'll get that muck in there.
Settle down,
Dusty said, pulling out a pouch of his own.
Calm down. Stay still.
No, I need... Fuck!
Starlight yelped and jerked as she tried to move her leg. Dusty placed a hoof on her thigh below the injury, and she seemed too distracted by the pain to object.
Settle down,
Dusty said.
You know the deal. Combat time means listen to me. Now settle down.
Starlight breathed through gritted teeth. Lacking any more productive, I placed a hoof comfortingly on the side of her neck.
We need to stop this bleeding,
Dusty said.
It's bad enough, I'm not going to trust anything short of a healing potion. You take one now, but that'll heal the bullet inside of you. You'll need surgery to get it out, and it won't be pleasant. Or I can try to get it out now. Which will it be?
Starlight's leg jerked again, making her cringe, and Dusty moved a hoof to put pressure directly on the wound, adding,
Make it quick, or I'm deciding for you.
Her response was a choked whine, and after a moment, her horn lit again, digging through her medical supplies to pull out a set of forceps, which trembled in her magic. Dusty caught its handle in his teeth and turned to her wound, while she pulled out a familiar pair of bottles, setting them aside her head, ready to use.
Okay, Dusty said around the forceps. This is going to hurt, but I need you to stay as still as you can.
He lowered his head, bringing the forceps towards the wound and moving his hoof away. Blood covered the underside of his hoof, flowing down the curve of Starlight's thigh. She tensed beneath my hoof. Then she yelled out,
Wait!
Dusty jerked, pulling back and placing his hoof over the wound again. He looked her way as the magic grabbed at her medical supplies again. This time, she produced a sealed hypodermic needle. She pried the cap off the needle, the tip wavering as she brought it to her thigh.
Let Whisper do that,
Dusty said around the forceps, his hoof still pressed to the wound. The needle halted as she looked up to me. I didn't need any more prompting, so I leaned in, gripping the body of the needle in my teeth, then brought it to her thigh, several inches from the wound.
Is here good?
I asked around it, and when she grunted and nodded, I leaned in further. The exposed inch of the thin metal brushed past her fur and slid easily into her flesh, and I pressed a hoof to the thin plunger to deliver the dose. She hissed faintly, but otherwise remained still. Finished, I slid the needle back out, taking the time to replace the cap before setting it aside. Starlight sucked in several deep breaths while Dusty waited patiently. Finally, she nodded.
Okay, do it.
The hoof pulled back again, and Dusty lined up the forceps. She tensed and I gave a gentle squeeze. Then the tip of the forceps slid into the wound, and she hissed, gritting her teeth. As they slid in further, that hiss turned into a low growl. There was a sharp clunk of metal on concrete behind me, and Sickle snorted. I turned her away momentarily, losing any common sense, as I shot a harsh glare at that brutish mare that could kill me with casual ease, but she wasn't even looking at us. Instead, she was turning away and walking towards the door. Just before she got there, she lowered her head, and her steel-shod hooves cracked against the concrete floor as she sprang into a full gallop, charging down the hall and out of sight. The same angry beep sounded, followed immediately by the sound of gunfire. I jerked in surprise. Somehow, Dusty didn't. The gunfire was matched with the deep thunks and pings of bullets striking thick metal, until it was replaced with a tortured sound of metal tearing and a ratcheting sound, like gears grinding. That lasted only a second before there was a loud pop, and Sickle shouted,
Fuck!
Dusty kept the forceps remarkably stable as he called out,
If you get yourself shot, you're gonna have to wait your turn!
Sickle's reply echoed down the hall,
Fuck you too, Dirt!
Focusing on his work, Dusty slid the forceps in deep enough that his muzzle was almost touching Starlight's thigh. He bit down on the grips, and I actually heard metal scrape faintly on metal as Starlight cringed. He had to back out a bit, parting the grips once more, and tried again. This time, it clamped down on something. Starlight growled louder as he pulled, finally blurting out,
That's not the bullet!
It is,
Dusty assured her.
It's not-
Dusty pulled free. Starlight's growl of pain faded to deep breathing as she looked up at him. Clasped in the forceps was the remains of a bullet. The front of it had been completely smashed in and flared out wider than the base, looking more like a mushroom than a bullet. And it was also smeared in blood. Dusty set the forceps down beside the other medical supplies, then pulled a small sturdy vial from a pouch, a healing potion.
Wait!
Starlight said, her attention finally pulling away from the bullet. Her magic grabbed one of her bottles, floating it in a shaky grip.
Gotta sterilize. Clean. No infection.
Dusty took the bottle, then frowned.
You shouldn't use this on open wounds,
he said, and after checking the other bottle, quickly swapped them.
This will do.
He popped open the cap, squirting the fluid into the wound. Starlight hissed a little, but remained still. The fluid washed away most of the blood, and Dusty used a bit of gauze to wipe around the wound. Then he brought the healing potion out and removed the stopper. He poured a little of it into the wounds, then passed it to me.
Have her drink that,
he said as he grabbed a magic-laced bandage, pressing it into the wound with a bloody hoof. Starlight blinked a few times, having difficulty focusing on the potion I held out to her. I hoped it was the painkillers dulling her senses rather than blood loss. Her horn lit, taking the vial, and she downed it. After a minute of waiting, Dusty peeled back the bandage, washing away a little more blood to get a better look at the wound before pressing it back into place.
Okay, bleeding stopped or close to it.
He retrieved a roll of gauze before turning it to me.
Lift her hind leg so I can wrap it.
Starlight spoke up.
I can lift... Ow!
She gritted her teeth again, her leg dropping again.
And that's why I asked Whisper to do it,
Dusty said, keeping his hoof onto the bandage. Starlight grumbled something under her breath as I scooted down, gently sliding my forehooves under her thigh and knee to lifting up the leg. I was met with a wet feeling of blood. There was a lot of blood. Not an excessive amount, mind you, there was no spreading pool of it beneath her. It wasn't enough that I worried for her life, but still, it was enough to be concerning. The entire front of her thigh was slick with blood, and it had run down her lower belly to her other leg. It seemed like so much blood for such a tiny little hole. I was relieved to see the corner of her mouth quirk upwards, despite all that.
Hey, Dusty?
Yeah?
Your bedside manner sucks.
He paused in his rapping, then he laughed softly, his hooves resuming their task.
Hey, I thought I was being nice. I even gave you a say in your treatment. Medics don't usually do that, you know.
She chuckled a little when he finished up. I gently set her leg down again, then wiped my bloody hooves against the ground. It didn't do much good. Sickle returned, grumbling as she wiped at her muzzle, and I reflected at that, with her blades washing clean by the flooded tunnel. The violent ex-raider was possibly the least bloody of the group, and we had only just started.